time for Drew's News, your daily scratch and sniff of the good news sticker. With me at the desk, if you scratch him, he smells like a strawberry. It's Rosie, Ross Mathews.
Yes, I do. Want to scratch?
Well, this year marks the 25th anniversary of the movie Scream. Rossi and I sat down to talk about the making of the original film with someone very special.
That's right, Drew. We got the scoop from Casey Becker herself in Everything Iconic, Drew's News Edition, with the one and only Danny Pellegrino.
With us at the desk, he dissects and respects all things pop culture on the Iconic, Everything Iconic podcast. Please welcome the one and only Danny Pellegrino.
Oh,
hi, Danny.
Hello. Thank you for having me. Mm-hmm. I'm so thrilled to be here to talk about one of my favorite topics. We're talking about Scream. Now, the Scream franchise is truly legendary. Drew appears in just the first 10 minutes, but I feel like it's one of the most memorable on-screen performances.
Thank you.
They're doing a new Scream in January.
Talk about an approach to a reboot. They're keeping the Scream reboot just under the tightest of wraps. People really don't know anything about it. But it sounds like they've got a very unique in to how they're going to reboot it, which I really respect because it's not easy to do that.
Right, right. I'm so excited. And Courtney Cox, David Arquette, and Nev Campbell are coming back.
Yep.
So we know what happens next. Drew, we got to talk about the filming of that. Did you know it would have such a memorable impact?
Well, I was producing the movie silently. So that's basically, you know, trying to get the project off the ground without a credit. Which was fine. I just really believed in the project. I thought the writing was something that felt very different. I feel like the horror genre is very cyclical, and it had been 10 years since Nightmare on Elm Street, which is actually why we ended up going to Wes Craven, who directed Nightmare on Elm Street. And before that, it was like the John Carpenter Halloween. And I just thought, like, every decade, someone really knocks it out of the park in this genre, and I was convinced that this script was that. So I was really passionate about it. And one night, was at my apartment in New York, and I had just this weird revelation, and I called the other filmmakers, and I said, is there any chance, because I was attached to play the Sydney character, I said, is there any chance
the main character?
Yes.
Really?
Is there any chance you would let me play the girl that gets killed in the beginning? Because this is what I want to accomplish with that. In every horror film, you know, it's like that the hand just goes, you know. Yeah. It's like they just get away. They're tugging at, like, their pant leg, probably like some dog in the park right here. And, you know, you kind of always have this, like, tension, but you kind of know your hero is going to make it. And I thought, what if I die? And then it'll be like all bets are off. Anybody could get killed in this movie. And we would take away that sort of cliche safety net of the girl always gets away. So I thought this was the best way I could serve this movie and this script that I so believed in.
I love that. I didn't know that, Drew.
Yes. So I died, and that's, and then that's it. I'm out.
So you mean you're not coming back for the reboot?
Well, I have to say, as much as I believed in the movie, I was a new producer, and I wasn't thinking franchises at that point. I didn't think franchise until Charlie's Angels. So I had no idea it would get to a second, a third, a fourth, a fifth. And I'm just so glad it did, because it's a testament to, I think, what we all believed in early on, which, by the way, Scream was originally called Scary Movie.
Really?
Yes.
Can I ask a really frivolous question?
Please.
How'd you decide that hair? You guys remember
the
that blonde
so
with the bangs and the bob? How'd you do it? Was that a wig?
It was a wig. Mm-hmm. And I asked, do you guys obviously know the movie Scarface?
Of course.
So Michelle Pfeiffer's hair in Scarface was the image I took to the wig maker. And I said, I want this. Exactly this.
Wow.
Now, the Scream poster sort of became the blueprint for horror movie posters. Did you know you were going to be front and center on it? I mean, was that part of the idea?
No, I had no idea. We all showed up at the shoot that day. And, you know, I really think what they did with the poster was just really graphic and cool. You know, it kind of could have been anyone's face. It was more about the expression and the feeling it bestowed. So I didn't feel like it took away from anything. I thought it just added to everyone's secret sauce. And it was just a really strong cast.
Did they ever ask you to, like, appear in any of the sequels, like in a flashback or something like that?
No, I think everyone kind of accepted I died so dramatically that there was no coming back. But again, this is my point, whether it's a Charlie's Angels or a Scream or, you know, a Matrix. When you go into an origin story, anything is possible because you're going back in time. Mm-hmm. So, you know, hey, who knows?
Yeah.
Maybe one day it'll happen.
We got to find that wig.
Yeah, I still have the wig.
Oh my God.
I have all the wigs.
Okay, wait, can we all go see Scream, the reboot part 5 together with you and the wig?
You know what? Please. I would love nothing more. Will you two, can I be your date?
I would love it.
Can I wear the wig?
Yes! Absolutely. Well, thank you, Ross. Thank you, Danny Pellegrino. Listen to his iconic podcast, Everything Iconic, right now.